Hello and welcome. I'm Raghav and today we will learn how to use uiautomator viewer tool to find object locators on mobile device, and we will see both on Windows and Mac, and this will be very easy and very interesting. Step number one is we have to connect our mobile device to our computer or laptop. We can do this through a cable like a USB cable or through Wi-Fi, and we have learned both of these methods earlier. So just in case you have any issues in this process, you can go to my channel on YouTube, which is Automation Step by Step. And if you go to the playlists here, you will find a playlist for Appium. So you will go to the Appium playlist and here you will find these videos. So here is a video on how to connect real Android device on Windows and how to connect real Android mobile device on Mac operating system. So you can watch this in case you have any issues. And once you have done that, you can run the command adb devices to check your connected devices. So if you are on Windows, you can go to your command line and here you can run the command adb devices and it will show you the list of devices attached. So on my Windows, there is no device attached, but if I go to my Mac and go to terminal and say adb devices, you can see it is showing me two devices attached, and actually this is a single Android phone. I have attached it through a USB cable and I have also attached to this device through Wi-Fi, so that is why it is showing me two entries here. So once you can see your device ID, then go to the next step, which is we have to start the uiautomator tool, and this is step number three. So on Windows, we can go to the Android SDK folder. So on Windows here, you can go to your Android SDK folder. So in my case, it is on, I have saved it on D drive, and under tools, I have this Android SDK. And again, this is something we have done earlier in the earlier session. So you can see this, if you see, actually this is covered in the same session, how to connect real Android mobile device on Windows and Mac. The downloading of SDK and then extracting platform tools folder is covered in that video itself, so you can watch that. I will also make this link available in the notes, so just in case you have any issues, you can watch this. And then you can go inside the folder and go inside tools, and you will either find uiautomator here, or if you do not find it here, you can go to the bin folder and you will find this uiautomator viewer bat. You can just go here and either double click, so it will start the uiautomator viewer tool, or you can also start it from command line. So this should start the uiautomator tool on Windows, and you can see this has started this tool. Or you can also go to the command line and go to the bin folder. A shortcut is I will directly go to the address bar and say cmd, and it will start command line on the same address. So you can see this is Android SDK tools bin, and if I say here uiautomator viewer bat and say enter, it will again start my uiautomator viewer tool. Now here also make sure that you have added the path of this bin folder and the Android SDK in your environment variable. So if I go to my environment variables and show you, I will go to the environment variables, and here you can see I have set the Android home to the folder Android SDK. So you can also create a new environment variable and set Android home to this in case it is not already set. And if I go to path and edit, in the path you can see I have added both my platform tools and bin folder here. So you can also use this and make sure that you have this, and you can start your uiautomator viewer like this. And on Mac, you can just go to terminal and type uiautomator viewer. Just you have to make sure that the folder for Android SDK and platform tools should be set in your environment variables, and this again we have learned in this video on how to connect real Android device on Mac OS. So I will just go to my terminal and say uiautomator viewer and click enter, and this should start my uiautomator viewer here. So you can see now this is started, and then the next step is I just have to open the application on my mobile device, and then on the uiautomator viewer I have to capture the screen. So I will just show you my mobile device on my desktop so that you can see this. So I will just go here, and you can see this is the screen of my mobile device, and I can go to, let us say I will go to this calculator, and this is now open. And now if I go to my UI automator here and I click here capture screen, so you can see there are two tools or two icons. This is device screenshot, which will take the entire UI automator dump, and then we have this which will show us a compressed hierarchy. So you can select anyone. I will click on this, and here because I have more than one devices attached, it is giving me a drop down list to select the device and say okay. Now at this case, if you are finding an issue or error that could not find the device, make sure that you are able to connect to your device, and when you run ADB devices, when you run this command, your device should be available here. So once you have done this, you can see my mobile screen is here, and now wherever I will click, I can see this. So if I expand this, so you can see this is the UI automator tool. On this right side, on this right side, you can see we have all this hierarchy of the frames, and then the object specific locators or properties are here. On the left side, you can see the mobile screen or the snapshot of the mobile screen. And here, if I want to capture object or elements or locators for any object, I can just click and it can capture this. Now you can also save this. For example, I want to save it for later use. I can just click here. This is the save button. So I will say save, and it will say it will get saved here. And whenever I have to open, now in case your mobile device is not connected to the system and you have saved your screenshot, you can just go here to open and browse the PNG file, and then browse the UI XML dump, which will be UIX extension, and say open and say okay, and it will open the screenshot here, and then you can again locate the elements. Now you can see it is able to locate the elements here, and then we can use these element locators in our script. So if I show you, this was a earlier project that we created in our this series of Appium, and this was the calculator test, and you can see these element locators we had put here using the Appium Desktop Inspector. And you can see we have used the ID here, so you can see the ID of this two button is this, and if you go to the UI automator, you will find the same thing. So if I go here and click on two, you can see the resource ID is this, and this is exactly what I have used here. And similarly, if I go to plus button, I can see the resource ID is this, and this is what I have used here. Now you can use multiple ways. So if you go to your script and say driver.findElement, you can see we have a mobile element, and we have by name, by ID, by XPath. So I can also say findElement, and I will say by.XPath, and I can give some XPath here. So for example, if I'm getting a resource ID, that will be the best way, because this is the ID which is unique. In case you do not get, you can create your XPath. So you can just say this is my class. So I will say image button, and then I will say at, let me say I want to use something else, maybe a resource ID is here, so I will directly use this, and I will say at resource ID equals to this, and that's it. So I can find it like this, and then there are other ways. So basically we need to get all these locators from here, and you can see a hierarchy here. So I can go to any of the buttons. I can also search from here. So if I search for multiply, you can see it has highlighted the multiply button and it is highlighted here. If I go to here and say divide and hit enter, it has highlighted the divide button and it is showing me in the hierarchy here, and these are the object properties. So I can use this in my code. So this is how you can use UI Automator tool to find objects on your mobile device that you can use in your automation scripts. I hope this session was very useful for you. Thank you for watching.